Archbishop Joseph Naumann is a leader in the church who has always advocated for the lives of the unborn. Now he's urging Catholics in his state to cast their ballots in favor of the Value Them Both Amendment. Naumann has spoken with clarity about how we in the church must always oppose abortion, as this is a preeminent moral issue. He strongly supported Archbishop Cordiglione's recent move to bar House Speaker Nancy Pelosi from receiving communion due to her brutal support for abortion. We spoke with the Archbishop about the importance of Catholics engaging in the public sphere, even those who live in states that are increasingly becoming more pro-abortion, like New York and California. I am here in the Archdiocese of Kansas City with Archbishop Joseph Naumann. Thank you so much for joining me today.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, Prudence, for the chance to be with you and your viewers.
Of course. Archbishop Naumann, I'd like to ask you about your thoughts on the overturn of Roe versus Wade. How have Kansans responded to this amazing victory?
Well, I think certainly within the church and within the pro-life community, it's been a cause for great celebration. And for many of us, myself included, I was not sure I would ever see this day. So I think for many of us, it's been like the Berlin Wall coming down.
Right.
Almost something that we thought would never happen, but an answer to prayers. And there's so many people in the pro-life movement and network that have worked heroically and sacrificed heroically to make this possible. But of course, there are others that have become convinced, I think, because of 50 years of legalized abortion, that we can't survive as a society without the ability to kill our own children. Mm-hmm. And it's really tragic to see the viciousness. And unfortunately, we've had at least one episode of vandalism at one of our churches here, but a lot of other stealing of signs and defacing of our signs and kind of organized efforts. And what I would call almost bullying by the opponents of the amendment here in Kansas. So it's energized both sides.
Mm-hmm.
And this effort here in Kansas to pass this amendment is really going to be about turnout, who turns out to the polls on August the 2nd.
Right, absolutely. And, overturning Roe versus Wade, it brings that debate back to the states. And like you said, that debate has become very real here in Kansas with this Value Them Both amendment on the ballot on August 2nd. How has the Catholic Church really engaged in making sure voters know about the Value Them Both amendment and the importance of getting out to vote on August 2nd?
The church, our approach to pro-life is comprehensive, and part of it is advocacy. And the church in the United States here, since its very inception, Archbishop Carroll thought it was not appropriate for us to endorse candidates, politicians,
right,
or parties. And so the church has chosen never to do that. I think that was a wise decision, that we don't want to stake the church's reputation to any particular politician or party.
I see, yes.
But this is not, it's not a vote on a politician, or it's a vote on an issue. And this is something that the church needs to be engaged with to form our people, especially on an issue that's so clear in its moral dimensions, as
right,
this one.
Archbishop, Kansas is a pro-life state where hopefully soon there will be an opportunity again to pass pro-life laws. But what's your advice to Catholics living in states that are controlled by Democrats, where soon, potentially, abortion could be legal up until the moment of birth?
Well, I think, another important part of our pro-life apostolate is education. And I think we've got to reach minds and change hearts.
Mm-hmm.
And by that, not the way that our opponents try to do things with violence and with bullying, but by simply presenting people with the truth. And, I think we've seen some incredible conversions, in these past 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
And people like Bernard Nathanson or Abby Johnson.
Right.
And so I think we don't have enemies, we just have pro-lifers who haven't yet been converted.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes,
I think we have to work on that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. And I also wanted to get your thoughts on just the state of our church right now. We have a president who claims to be Catholic, but he promotes abortion up until the moment of birth. He's
in the middle of instituting and playing out a whole of government response that would force Americans everywhere, many of them who are pro-life, people of faith, to pay for abortions with taxpayer dollars, to, you know, just step aside while abortion becomes the law of the land once again. How should we respond to these self-proclaimed, these baptized Catholics like Joe Biden and Nancy Pelosi as authentic Catholics trying to live out our faith?
Well, I think we have to pray for them. We have to pray for conversion of their hearts. But I think we also have to call them out. And I think as a bishop, I have a particular responsibility because when they say they're devout Catholics and then they do these egregious things against life and you know, are zealously promoting abortion, and the president's case saying he's going to bring every power of the federal government to keep abortion legal, to preserve Roe versus Wade, you know, that we have to, they begin to usurp the role of the bishop. And they're teaching people, hey, I'm Catholic, and I'm doing this, and you can be a good Catholic, and you can do this as well. So I think as bishops, we have to say, no, that's not your role. You may be elected, and you have a lot of authority in the civil area, but you don't teach what it means to be Catholic, and, and certainly what they're doing is not. And I was glad to hear the Pope recently said that President Biden's position is incoherent. To be doing what he's doing and then to claim to be Catholic.
Archbishop Naumann, thank you so much for joining us and for your courageous and clear leadership on life. God bless you.
Thanks, Prudence. Thanks for your work. This is my favorite EWTN show.
Oh, that's wonderful to hear. Thank you.
Thanks.